Here we have a question based on differential band break. I am marking this question. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. So let us start this problem by writing the data. First of all, I will mention the type of break. Here we are having differential band break. In the question it is given, a band break of bell type is as shown in figure. The diagram is given to us. Break drum is 40 cm in diameter. So the diameter of this drum is 40 cm. I'll write it as D is equal to 40 cm. So therefore the radius of break drum will be half of this. So it becomes 20 cm. Next, this would be 0.2 meter. Then the break drum is 40 centimeter in diameter, requiring a braking torque of 750 newton meter. Here braking torque value is given to us. So I'll write this value. T suffix B is equal to 750 newton meter. Next, two ends of the band are attached on the pins on opposite sides of fulcrum at 10 cm and 2 cm respectively. In the diagram, here in blue color which we are seeing, this is the fulcrum. So from fulcrum, one end of the band is attached at a distance of 10 cm. So this distance A which is given to us, this is the first distance which is 10 cm. So A is equal to 10 centimeters. Next, and the other end which is B, it is 2 centimeters. Coefficient of friction is 0.3, value of mu. This is the coefficient of friction between the brake band and the brake drum. Here we can see the brake band is red in color, and here we are having a brake drum which is shown in the black color. So the coefficient of friction between both of them is 0.3, and angle of contact is 225. The angle of contact of the brake drum and the brake band, this is given as the angle of contact, which I'll denote it by theta, and it is 225 degree given. Now this angle of 225 degree which they have given, we need to convert it into radians, because in the problem we would be requiring the angle in terms of radian. So here I'll convert it by multiplying it by pi and dividing it by 180. So theta becomes, it comes out to be 3.93 radians. Then the lever length is 60 cm. Lever length is from the fulcrum to the point of contact of the load. This is given as 60 cm. So L is equal to 60 cm. Here the question is, find effort required at the end of the lever. This effort which we are seeing at the end of the lever, this effort when it is applied at the end of the lever, this will result in the braking action, because when we are applying an effort in the downward direction, this lever would be moving up, that is the end which is attached here, this would be moving up, and the belt would be tightened along this brake drum, and that would result in braking action. So we need to find out how much is this value of P. So the unknown is the effort here. So this is the data which we have on differential band break. Now let us try to get the solution for this problem. Now since in this problem braking torque is given, I will start the problem from braking torque. I'll say that since braking torque is given by The formula is, here I'll keep this as equation number 1. In breaking torque, we have T1 and T2. T1 means tension in tight side. T2 is tension in slack side. R is the radius of brake drum. Now, if we see in this question, the brake drum is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. The direction of rotation of the drum is given to us. When the drum rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the belt will be pulled from here because it is rotating in anti-clockwise direction and delivered towards B. So the belt is being pulled from A and it is being delivered towards B. So here I am having tension in tight side and here there is tension in slack side, which is T2. So I'll say that therefore belt tension ratio is given by, the formula is T1 by T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. The value of mu is 0.3, theta is 3.93 radians. So from this I'll get the relation of T1 T2, that comes out to be 3.25. So T1 is 3.25 times of T2. This I'll keep it as second equation. Now I'll again go back to equation number 1, put all the values. I know braking torque. I can just substitute the value of T1 in terms of T2. Radius of the brake drum is given. So from that I would be getting the value of T2 first. So I'll say that therefore, put all values in equation 1. Here, braking torque is given to us in this problem. The value of TB, it is 750, is equal to T1 is 3.25 times of T2 minus T2 into R, it is the radius of brake drum, and the value is 0.2 meter. So from this, if I calculate, I would be getting the answer of T2, and that value is, it is 1668.08 Newton. Next, I'll say that put T2 in equation 2. Therefore, T1 is equal to 3.25 into T2, and the value is 1668.08. Therefore, T1 value, it comes out to be 5418.08 Newton. After getting T1 and T2 values, now since in the question it is mentioned that we have to calculate the value of effort applied, so for that we will have to take moments of all forces about the fulcrum. So next thing, I'll draw the pulley again, or you can say the brake drum. Now the rotation is given in the problem. This brake drum is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So when it rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the belt is pulled from this end, which is at A. So this becomes tension in tight side and it is being delivered at B. So here we have tension in slack side, which is T2, and at the end of the lever we are having the effort which we want to calculate. Now I would be taking the moments of all forces about this fulcrum, which I'll denote it by F. So the next step is taking moments about the fulcrum is equal to zero. Therefore, summation of moments of forces about the fulcrum is zero. Here I will take clockwise moment positive and anticlockwise moment negative. Therefore, P into this distance between fulcrum and the point where effort is applied. This is the length of the lever. So it is P into L clockwise. Next, T2, the distance between fulcrum and the end of band which is attached here. It is B and it comes out to be in clockwise direction. So it is positive plus T2 into B. T1 into A, that is anticlockwise, it's equal to 0. Therefore, effort P will be equal to, if I shift these terms on the other side, it will be T1 into A minus T2 into B divided by L. I'll put the values which I have found out. T1 was 5418.08 into A, the value it's given in the problem, A is 10 centimeters, so into 10 minus T2 value, it was 1668.08 into B value is 2 divided by the length of the lever, it was 60. So from this, if I calculate, I would be getting my final answer of effort, and that is 847.41 Newton. That's the answer. So for this differential band break, at the end of the lever we must be applying an effort of 847.41 Newton in order to apply the brakes, or in other words, to stop this drum from rotating. So with this, we complete the problem.